Let's just hope this works out.
I know this party is for two dogs, Josephine and Napoleon, but I want you guys to treat it as any other party, okay? They're my clients, so you guys have to be as professional as possible. You guys can have a drink. That's totally fine. Just one, okay? No more than that.
Of course.
And okay, cool. Any questions?
Treat it as any other boys.
Treat it as any other client. Yeah, they're dogs, but
I'm gonna write customer.
Okay.
I had only become a wedding planner not too long ago. I had taken an online course for about 3 weeks, and then when that was done, they sent me a link, and I could print off my certificate. And this is my first big gig, so I thought, you know, hit the big times. But I heard about Napoleon and Josephine, so I thought, oh, that's some nutty names. That should be some quirky characters. And they're not people. They're dogs. It's a dog wedding. Did you know? Okay, it's a dog wedding. I thought I would get to put this on a resume, and I already have, and I can't, because this is bad.
That's so adorable.
I think they're taking it way too far. The wig, that's where I drew the line. The next time I see them walking down the street with Josephine's wig on, I'm crossing to the other side. That's all I know.
Photos today.
Hi.
Oh yes, he's in love.
I mean, I love Ken to death, but really, with your dogs getting married, it's kind of embarrassing. Like, if it was me, I would be kind of embarrassed. And I mean, like, it's free booze and food, so it's not too bad, but it's kind of stupid. I'm gonna be honest, like, really, who has a wedding for their dogs?
Oh, I think we have somebody coming at the door. Oh, you're back. Oh my god, you guys were a long time. Were you guys making out or what?
If anyone finds it too hot, there are chairs outside and there's room outside as well.
Okay, good. If you don't know how to do it,
I'll show you how to walk the dog. So, yeah, Casper can be a bit of an outsider, and for good reason. My aunt came over the other day to visit, and he went into her purse and took out $10.
He started to take the $10 and run away.
He ran away?
Ran away. And I said, Casper, please give me the $10. And I ran away with him, but he go inside the furniture. And I said, oh, Casper, give me $10. I don't know where I did. The $10 was.
He even took her dentures from the purse, and he ended up making a chew toy out of it.
I surprised because he opened the purse. The purse was closed. That's my surprise.
Yeah, he's into younger women. But there's a bit of controversy because Casper, the best man, likes the groom.
Oops. Oh,
no.
Sorry.
Oh, yeah. He's a humper.
He is.
Oh, look at that, kids. There we go. Look at that. Whoa. You want to treat Casper? Look at that. Oh.
What are you doing?
Oh, look at Napoleon without his teeth. He's just gumming them up.
Myself, I'm not necessarily the biggest doggy guy. I didn't really grow up around animals. Every time I see Josephine, and I mean this in every proper sense of the word, that bitch tries to bite my hands off, and I am none too impressed with that. So, you know, I thought I'd make peace with the whole doggy scavenger hunt, follow me around with treats. All right, doggies, who wants to have a scavenger hunt? I thought it was gonna go off without a hitch. I mean, dogs love this kind of stuff. Dog treats, right? They weren't buying it at all. They quite frankly, could have cared less. Come on, guys. Anybody? Anybody? Not even Napoleon? Come on, I know you love food. Anybody? Dogs? I suppose, in my defense, what maybe would have been a better plan would have been having this doggy scavenger hunt before we handed out the doggy buffet and they were all full. I think that probably would have been a better idea. But you know, it's my first dog wedding. It's my first time really working with Cherish Events. So you win some and you lose some, right?
There has been a little mess outside, so I'd like you to take that and go and clean it up, please.
I'm on it.
Good.
This is the fatness. Yes. Yeah. With his tired little legs.
Desi said, he said to me.
Yeah. No, I mean,
this is fine. Is like before the party starts. This and this, I walk on the other side of the street.
I understand that.
I know. It's her I would day. Be the same way.
Exactly. It's her day. She wants the attention to be on her, and it should be. She's gorgeous.
Yeah. Yeah. Exactly.
I think this doggy wedding is probably the second dumbest thing I've seen in my lifetime so far. And this is also probably in the top five worst moments of my life.
Not how I thought it was. Hey guys, just coming in to check in. Everything's going well for you guys?
Fabulous. Having a great time.
Good. Just a couple things. You just need to open up a little bit more, be a little more personable with the guests, okay?
Basically. Some pep.
Little more pep. Just smile. Just have fun. Make sure
they're... I kind of already feel like I'm on like an 8 or a 9. Did you want like...
10. Be a 10. Yeah. Can you be a 10? It's just about smiling. It's just... You can do it. Okay. I know you can do it. Just smile. Just be a little bit more personable. That's basically it, okay?
Give some pep.
Right. Yeah.
Just try to be a little more like me, Jamie.
Well, no. 10, not a 15.
At the wedding shower, Justin came up to me in the kitchen and said, "Hey, have you been drinking?" And I mean, he had told us we could drink. And he said one drink. And I'm Irish, so one drink means like four drinks.
I said one glass, and I think I've seen you had about four. So, please. No, that's enough.
Yeah, I had four drinks, and I was a little tipsy, but it didn't impede my ability. I was out playing with the dogs, I was out visiting with the guests. I mean, I was on top of it all.
So, get to a 10 for you, and down to a 10 for you, not 15, not 8, 10.
You're on a
okay?
Different scale.
Fine. All right, thanks, guys.
Thanks, Justin.
Rick.
Back to work.
Today's Thursday. Yeah, so today's Friday. We have a week. Oh goodness. Lots to do in a week, but everything's gonna be fine. I mean, we've been planning for a good while now, and have most of the details. We just have a couple things to finalize. And Adam, Josephine's made a mess outside, so can you take care of that?
Yeah, no problem, Justin. Thanks. So glamorous. That's...
Ugh!
Gross. Oh, God.
Well, Napoleon and Josephine want to thank everybody for coming to their Jack and Jill shower for the big wedding next week. And we hope everybody had a great time, the dogs included. We had a little doggy buffet. We had lots of food for everyone else. So I want to thank everybody for coming, and we'll see you next week at the wedding, the big Chihuahua wedding. Well, that was the Jack and Jill shower. I think it went pretty well.
I think so too. Like, I mean, all of our friends and our family members, they all showed up.
Family, yes. Yeah. Your Aunt Antonia was there. Yeah.
She had a lot of fun.
The wedding planner, you know, one of the wedding planners, one of them was a little bit tipsy. But, you know what? They pulled it off. I was really pleased.
However, the scavenger hunt, that didn't seem to go too well.
No, not really. You know, even I wouldn't have gone after those bones.
But what I will say is that I think you're onto something because... Oh. If this Jack and Jill was any indication, I think the wedding is going to be quite the success.
I think so too. Ooh, absolutely. The dogs are liking it.
They're going to have a lot of fun.
I am actually not a doctor. I was kicked out of veterinary school because of my, unnormal practices. But I am actually one of the top people in the field, small field, and I guarantee that I can treat your animal. Welcome back.
Thank you.
Thanks for having us.
Ken, Ursula.
Mm-hmm. They're much better.
Much better.
Yes, Napoleon is much, much better, and I'll tell you what I think, Doc, the issue was.
What's that?
I think that he saw Josephine wearing her wigs. He immediately grabbed one night and took it to his bed, so I put it on him, and ever since then he's been happy. So I think he's into a little bit of cross-dressing. I'm not sure, but he seems to be happier. Look at him. Look.
Honestly, I think the wigs are a bit much, especially for Napoleon. That's not really good for his self-esteem. As far as the wedding is concerned and whether or not the dogs are in love, I would say that yes, indeed they are, from my knowledge of love, which is unfortunately very small. You know, I think maybe he's confused, but if he is confused, it's because you
I'm
put
confused.
A wig on him. No, sexually confused, your dog. It's because you put a wig on him.
Yeah.
He's being humped by another dog. What's Josephine's reaction to this when he's
Oh,
being
she
humped?
Watches. She it's like a menage.
Does she bark as well?
She partakes. She gets in there. Yeah.
So the dog whisperer, well, whatever he is, he's not a doctor. I think he failed vet school. I'm not sure whether he helped us or not, or helped Napoleon and Josephine. He was very sincere. He talked slow. He had great shirts. I did like the shirts.
Oh, really? I thought his shirts cried out help.
Oh, okay.
He's the one that needed the help.
The shirts, I don't always wear the shirts. They, I actually had them tailor-made for me. Designer shirts. I just like to have fun, pretty much, for the most part. I'm a fun person. I like animals.
So we're all ready for the wedding.
We are. Yeah. We've got everything in place. We've got the flowers, mm-hmm. the invitations, we've got the catering, the cake. You got the liquor license, right?
Oh yeah, absolutely.
You got to have that, for sure.
Absolutely.
And is he coming?
Well, yeah, I mean, he's in the wedding party. He's the best man.
But I'm telling you, for the rehearsal, for the wedding, everything, it's a no-humping zone. You know what? We don't need any more controversy. He can't be humping the fat one.
Relax, he'll be on his best behavior.
Yeah,
he's been feeling a little neglected. Let's just hope all the dogs from the wedding party actually show up.
I know. That dogs, people, and a little bit of booze, who knows what's going to happen.
Okay, so I just want to quickly go over how the room's going to be set up so you know exactly where you're going to be going and standing and that type of stuff.
Working on this wedding has been great fun. I've never worked on a dog wedding before.
You guys are going to be entering from the back. We'll go through
It's pretty
this
similar
hall.
To a human wedding. There is the bridezilla, Josephine, and Ken a bit too.
The wedding planner is screwed up.
Ken has been crazy. Like crazy, calling down everybody. He has been such a bitch. But I totally understand, it's his babies, you know, it's all good. I just really hope it all turns out really well for him. Because if not, no, not good.
I'm Jennifer Ego, the founder of K9 Rescue Me. We are the beneficiary of the wedding between Napoleon and Josephine, and we encourage more and more people to get out and do creative things with their pets to help raise money for dogs in need across Canada.
So we're just gonna do a quick run through, maybe once or twice, make sure everybody knows exactly what they're doing. I want you to stay on the whoop station, please. Just make sure that you're cleaning up messes right away. And you just so, basically I will be standing here, and once Ted introduces you, I will say, go ahead. So if I can get Timber, Kate, and Christy.
My name is Christy, and I've been invited to the dog wedding with my daughter, Kate. We are neighbors of Ken.
Timber!
And I gotta tell you, here we are, sitting there having breakfast one morning, and he says, will you be in our dog wedding? We're like, dog wedding? What are you talking about, dog wedding? So he gets my daughter very excited for the dog wedding. Here we are at the rehearsal. We're on our way through it. This is absolutely crazy. We hope that Timber A, who I'm quite over, by the way, and B, our daughter, can make it down the aisle.
There we go. Look at Timber.
I'm an old friend of Ken's, and I have to say that it really is about time that Napoleon and Josephine got official, because they have lived together for so long. Although I do really wonder whether it's going to last.
I've always believed that we are the voice for animals, and we protect them from cruelty, which is wonderful about this event, because we also have canine rescue that proceeds go to them. But I also know that we now have the voice to speak on behalf of them about love. And that's what this wedding is all about. It's about the fact that they can express their love, and they have every right to.
Casper's not dealing with this too well, as you can imagine. I mean, he's lovesick for Napoleon. Every time he tries to hump him, Josephine gets in the way. So, I mean, how can this dog really be happy about this wedding? But, you know, we try to include him. He said he'll be the best man, but he might be putting his paw up and stopping the wedding. I don't know.
So we had the rehearsal today, and let me tell you, I never want to get married. Do you want to get married? Are you sure you want to get married to him? Yeah? Yes. Yeah, that was a nod. That was a pause up. She wants to get married. Look at Josephine. Look at that. Look into the camera, Josephine. Are you all ready to get married? Are you all... Isn't she cute?
Hello? Yes, it's Desi speaking. Hi, how you doing? Good. Just getting some stuff finalized for the wedding, you know? Last minute stuff. Yeah. So what's up? Okay. Yeah, I just really can't believe that this is your position now. Yeah, the wedding's in 3 days, though. Okay, well, I've got to call him right away. I've got to let him know that this is your stance and what you're pulling out. Okay, I'll call you back. Bye.
So I'm in Montreal, about to go on air. I'm shooting a commercial. I get a phone call from you, and it's about the charity that we've chosen for the big Chihuahua wedding. And I can't believe this. That charity has now decided to pull out because they don't like where I'm selling the dog products to, the chain of stores. Is that not, what is wrong with people? Like, is that not the most stupid thing you've ever heard?
Unbelievable.
Them telling me where we can sell the pet care products.
What are we gonna do now?
Well, we're gonna have to find a solution to that one.
I know.
Okay. Let's get up. Okay. Come on. Hey, you. Let's go. Come on. Come on, Josephine. Come on.
Everybody having a ball. Yippee-yi-yo. I tell the fellas start your name calling.
Oh, yeah.
Yippee-yi-yo. And the girls respond to the call. And the blue dog shows down. Who let the dog out?
We're done. Look at you. You're going to be so pretty for your wedding. Oh, nice and clean. Who let the dog out?
I see little speed load head up. She really wants to skip town. Scruffy, back scruffy, get back, you flea infested mongrel.
There's something definitely wrong. Did you see that? I was in the shower with my two dogs. That's not good. Let's go. Get in. Go in. Come on, Peanut. Jump in. There you go. Good. Let's go. There, okay.
Welcome back to the Fairmont Royal York, Mr. Cossack.
Thank you.
We're very pleased to be here. It's a special occasion.
So do you believe that? We got the Royal York Hotel?
Totally.
And on top of it, we got the Prime Minister's suite.
Who would have thought?
I know.
Who let the dogs out? Who let the dogs out?
We are. Prime Minister's suite. There you go, kids. There, go. Look at that. Isn't that fun? You know what? I wonder how our present Prime Minister would feel about the wedding, the couple, spending a night in his bed along with us.
I don't think he'll take it too
No, long. I don't think so.
Not at all.
Oh, who's that?
Room service.
Oh. Come on in. What are you?